हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, गुड नून. मैं सेल्फ सुनील सोनिग्रा एंड टुडे विल कंटिन्यू विद द डिस्कशन ऑफ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ जीटीयू एग्जामिनेशन क्वेश्चन पेपर फ्रॉम द एग्जाम डिसम्बर 2010 द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ मैकेनिकल ड्राफ्टिंग. प्रीवियसली वी सॉल्व्ड थ्री क्वेश्चंस, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 1A, 1B, and 2A, एंड नाउ वी कंटिन्यू विद द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ फर्दर क्वेश्चंस. एंड द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन 2B, विच इज आस्क्ड लाइक दिस. Figure 3 shows view of an object. Draw development of the surface of part A. Here, this is the given diagram. Nothing is given. Only cut portion is shown over here. It is not mentioned which solid it is. Here, diameter 30 is written, phi 30. It means that it's a circular base. The base is circular. And front view is triangle, hence we assume that it would be a cone. So this is a cone which is cut like this. Here cut portion is there and here arc is cut. So to draw the solution of development of the cone, how to draw? So for that, first we have to draw its top view. So for that, draw axis like this from its front view, and vertical axis and horizontal axis like this. After drawing this axis, take projections from endpoints 1 and 2. From these two endpoints, taking projections and draw a circle of diameter 50 millimeter. So this is the top view of given solid. And now to draw its development, this is the equation. Theta is equal to radius upon length into 360 degree, where R is the base circle radius. Means radius of this circle, that is 25 millimeter, diameter is 50 millimeter, so radius is 25, and L is the slant height or length of the slant edge or true length of the edge of this cone. So this point to this point represent the true length, or this point to this point. The height is 70 and the length of this slant edge is 75 mm in this case. If we draw this triangle to the scale and measure this distance, it would be 75 or around 75. It may be 76 or 74. We can take 75. Put these values in this equation. R is equal to 25, L is equal to 75. So 25 upon 75, that is 3. 1 upon 3 into 360, that is equal to 120 degree. So this is first step to find out the angle theta, that is 120 degree. Now, to draw the development of this solid, name these points. This is point number 1. This is apex point O. Here is point 1 dash. And here is point apex point O dash. O dash 1 dash are the imaginary generator. O dash 1 dash is imaginary generators over the periphery of this cone. And O1 is the top view of that imaginary generator. Now, from O dash, draw an angle which makes an angle of 120 degree with this O dash 1 dash slant edge. This is O dash 1 dash, and draw a line at an angle of 120 degree like this. At an angle of, extend this line. Now the angle between this line and this line is 120 degree. Then take O dash as a center, O dash 1 dash as a radius, and draw an arc like this. O dash center, O dash 1 dash radius, draw an arc. So this arc, this portion represents the development of the cone. If the cone is full cone, it is not cut anywhere, its development would appear like this. An arc having this included angle 120 degree and length of its slant edge is 75 millimeter. Now here, this cone is cut at certain portion, somewhere here, somewhere here. So to draw this developed portion, let me divide this circle into equal number of parts. Say here it is divided into 8 equal parts like this. So all these lines would be at an angle of 45 degree to each other. So these are the imaginary generators drawn in the top view. Similarly, project, name these points, point number 1, point number 2, 3, 4 and so on, like this. Here point number 6, 7 and 8. So 8 points are there over the periphery of the circle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Even this bottom portion is not needed, you can draw half circle as well. Now project these points in top view. So for that, draw vertical lines from 8, 7, 6 like this and project here like this. As we have divided this top view into 8 equal parts, divide this developed portion into 8 equal parts like this. First divide into 2 parts, again into 2 parts each like this, and also divide here like this. So in short, we have divided this cut portion into 8 equal parts similar to this circle. Circle is divided into 8 parts. This angle is also divided into 8 equal parts. Hence, this included angle would be 120 upon 8, 15 degree would be there. After dividing this into 8 equal parts, let me project the points on its front view like this. Name the points, point number 1, 2, 3, 4, point number 5 is here, here is point number 6, here is point number 7, point number 8 and point number 1, back to 1. First and last would be alike, both would be similar, and transfer these points, these imaginary generators to this front view like this. So these generators ODS 2 days. Here from here also draw vertical line, here also draw vertical line from 4 and 6 and this point to be joined with ODS. So these are the imaginary generators drawn over the outer surface of this cone. After drawing these generators, let me find out the points of intersection between this solid. Suppose this is the cut portion, and find out the point of intersection between this cutting plane and this imaginary generator. So this is the imaginary generator O2, this is the point of intersection. So from that point, draw a horizontal line, transfer it to its front view or its true length, and from that take ODS as a center, ODS to this point as a radius, draw an arc like this, and that arc will cut ODS to at this point. So this is the first point. Similarly, from here draw horizontal line like this, that will cut the true length at this point. Then take ODS as a center, ODS to this point as a radius, draw an arc, and that arc will cut ODS 3 or O3 at this point. This is point P3. Similarly, from here draw horizontal line like this, draw an arc, taking ODS as a center, ODS to this point as a radius, draw an arc, that will cut O4 at this point. So we have picked up 3 points. Fourth point would be on O1 over here. Now last point, next point is from here, intersection of this cutting plane and this slant edge, is this is the point. From that draw horizontal line, that will cut this true length over here, and from this take ODS as a center, ODS to this point as a radius, draw an arc, that arc will cut ODS 5 at one point over here. So this is point number P5. Similarly, draw arcs to 6, P6, this is point number 6, transfer it like this. Similarly, 7 would be here, transfer it from here to here like this, point number P7 on O7 generator, and from here on 8, from here draw a line, draw an arc, that will cut O8 at this point. Similarly, from here draw an arc, that will cut O1 at this point. So these are the points which we have located in this developed portion of this cone. If it is cut over here, these are the points. Now join all these points with a smooth curve like this. Because this is a cone, the developed portion would appear as a smooth curve. So join all these points with a smooth curve. So we have drawn this upper cut portion. Now think about this bottom cut portion, this radius 25 is given. So for that, we pick up this point. This point is on O1, so P1 point would be here. Pick up this point. So for that, draw horizontal line from here. From here, as we what we did over here, same exercise to be done over here. Find out point of intersection between the slant edge, this imaginary generator, this arc. So this is the point. And from that point, draw horizontal line that will cut the true length or slant edge over here. From this point, taking O dash as a radius, O dash to this point as a center, as a distance, as a radius, draw an arc that will cut O2 at this point. Now what's about this point? This point would be on 7 and 3. So on 3 and 7, two points would be there. But what's about between 2 and 3? So for that, let me do one exercise. Divide 2, 3 into two equal parts. Here 2, 3 into two equal parts. Like this. Similarly here on this side also point number 1, 8 and 7 would be there. Mirror to this. 1, 2 and 3. 1, 8 and 7 to the back side. 1, 8 and 7 over here. 3 points are there. Now what's about this midpoint between 6 and 7 and 2 and 3? So for that divide 6, 7, 7, 8 and 2, 3 into two equal parts like this. 7, 8. This is the line which divides 7, 8 into two equal parts, and this is the line which divides 2, 3 into two equal parts. From that, draw a straight vertical line, and this is the generator as shown by black line. This is the generator which shows this imaginary generator, and cutting point is here. So divide 2, 3, this point. This imaginary generator is in between 2 and 3. So here, put a point over here between 2, 3, like this, over here, and between 7 and 8, like this. So divide 7 and 8 into two equal parts, 2 and 3 into two equal parts, and draw this imaginary generator. Now, from here, where this imaginary generator cuts this cut portion, draw horizontal line from here, like this. Transfer it to true length, and O dash as a center, draw an arc. That arc will cut these two lines, one at over here, another at here. So these are the points, and as it's a cone, join all these points with a smooth curve from here to here, from here to here, and from this portion and from here. So this is the development of this cone. If it is cut over here and here, this would be the development of the portion. In examination, you have to draw in such a way that this portion, which is shown by blue colored like this, it should appear fully, and rest all should appear very light like this. These all lines should be light, and this should be full line, and this is the development of the given solid. This is answer number 2B. You write here, this is the answer or development. It's mandatory to write this equation, angle theta 120 degree, and this darkened portion. I hope the solution of this question is clear to you. Now we proceed further with question number 2B, which is asked for 7 marks. The data is given like this. A cylinder of 40 mm diameter and axis is 90 mm long is lying perpendicular on its base on horizontal plane. A cylinder is given. It is lying on its circular base on HP. So its top view would be circle and its front view would be a rectangle. It is penetrated by another cylinder lying such that its axis is inclined at 30 degree to HP and parallel to vertical plane. Another cylinder is there which makes an angle of 30 degree with horizontal plane, and its axis is parallel to vertical plane. The second cylinder is of same size of and height of first. So dimension of both the cylinders are alike, that is 40 mm diameter and 60 mm height, 90 mm height. It is bisecting coplanar axis of both the cylinders, means the axis of both the cylinders bisect each other, draw the curve of interpenetration in elevation. Here we have to draw the curve of intersection in its front view. So for that, let we assume first cylinder having diameter 40 millimeter and height 90 millimeter. So draw that cylinder like this. The diameter of the cylinder is given to us, that is 40 millimeter. So take 20 millimeter as radius and draw a cylinder or a circle below XY line like this. A circle below XY line having diameter 40 millimeter, means radius is equal to 20 millimeter. So this circle represents the top view of given solid, and draw an XY line over here to represent the intersection of horizontal plane and vertical plane. This is the XY line, and this cylinder height is given to us. So draw a cylinder rectangle of given height, that is 90 millimeter, like this. So this is the front view of the cylinder. Draw its axis as well. And of course, it would be needed to draw its axis in top view also. Draw here the axis like this. Height is given to us, that is 90 millimeter. Diameter is given to us, that is 40 millimeter. Now it is given that it is penetrated by another cylinder of the same dimension, that is 40 millimeter diameter, such that its axis bisects the axis of this cylinder.